Welcome to Excel Champs. In today's video, we are going to learn about six powerful methods to remove the duplicates from our data. First of all, we will use pivot tables to identify the duplicates in our dataset. Now here I have a small example. I have name of few students with the subject and the year of passing out. First of all, I'll create a pivot in the same Excel sheet. I'll go to insert a pivot table. Select existing worksheet and select a range here. I'm selecting this cell F22 and press OK. We will put the name in the rows, subject and then year. Now I have put everything in the rows. Now this looks quite confusing. We'll go to design and change the report layout. We'll go to show in the tabular form. Now here I'll again go to design, go to subtotals and do not show subtotals. Now here I got the name of the students, the subjects and the year of passing out. So these are my unique entries. Now let's try these out. Here I have a list of 13 students and here I got the list of 10 students. It means this data set contains 3 duplicate values. So this is how you can refine your data and get the unique values using a pivot table option. Now the second method is using Power Query. Now first of all, it is always advised to convert your data into a data table. How I will do this? I will simply click anywhere on my data and press Ctrl T from my keyboard and press Enter. Now this has changed into a table. Now what I will do is I will click on the first cell, go to the data and click on from table and range. Here my Power Query editor has opened. Now there are two methods of removing the duplicates. First of all, you can click on this table. You will get a few options and you can simply click on remove duplicates. Now here I got my 10 unique entries and my duplicate values, which were 3 in count, have been removed. Now I'll remove this step. Again, I got my 13 values. Now the second way is you can select your data, complete data set, go to home, click on remove rows and remove duplicates. It has again removed my duplicates from my data set and I got my unique values. Now I'll close and load to table on existing and I'll copy this here. So I got my unique values in the Excel sheet. Now the third method is using the inbuilt function COUNTIF or COUNTIFS. Now here we have only one single criteria, so we will use COUNTIF. Now to use COUNTIF, first of all, we will have to use a function called TextJoin. As the name suggests, this function will combine the given ranges into one single cell. First of all, I'll use TextJoin. I'll define a delimiter. Since I do not need a space, so we will leave this blank. I'll put true since I want to ignore my empty cells. And now I'll define my range. Press enter. So now you see the magic of converting this data into a range. I did not copy this formula till the end. It was automatically copied till the end. Now I'll use COUNTIF function in this range. First of all, the array is range. Now my range is this, column 1. And what is my criteria? I just want to check if this value is repeated in this given range. So I'll press enter. Again, I got 1. This 1 means that this entry is occurring once. And when I select 2, this means that this text is occurring twice. Now let's select the 2. So these are my repetitive values. Now the next method is using conditional formatting. Now here, let's try this conditional formatting. I'm selecting my data, go to home and conditional formatting, highlight cell rules which are duplicate values. Now you will see that it is going to highlight my values which are repeated. It has highlighted physics because it is occurring twice or more than 2 times in this column. But this again doesn't make sense because I want the combination of these 3 cells which combined are occurring twice. So what I'll do is again I'll join my cells using text join delimiter true and I'll select this range and press enter. So my cells are combined. Now we will use conditional formatting in this combined cell. I'll select my range, conditional formatting, highlight cells and duplicate values. You can always customize if you want to highlight these in red color, yellow, green, or you can also choose a custom color, border or any kind of format you like. So here we will keep it default and press OK. So these are the entries which are occurring twice or more than 2 times in my data. Now the next method is using the advanced filters. I'll go to data. I have an option here, advanced, which I believe most of you must not have used it. So I'll click on advanced. Now here I have two options, filter the list in place or copy to another location. We'll try both the options in this video. First of all, I'm using filter the list in place and I am selecting this range which is already selected. You can see, so no need to change it. Now I'm just clicking on this unique records only and press OK. Now you will notice my duplicate entries are hidden. It lies somewhere between the row 32 and 36. Only my unique values can be seen. Now I'll select this, again press Alt semicolon, Control C and paste here Control V. So you will see that all my unique values are copied. Now let's try the second option. I'm deleting this table. I'll click on name, go to data, advanced. Now I'm using the option of copy to another location. I'll click on copy to another location. Choose my range, which is already selected. Copy to, let me give this a new location. Let's say it's F22, unique records only and OK. Now this has copied only the unique entries in my data set to my new given range. Now the last option is the default option, which most of us are using. I'll select my range and you have this option, remove duplicates under data tools. I'll click on this. This will ask for a confirmation like, do you want to remove your duplicates from all the columns or from a single column? Since these columns are interconnected with each other, so I will select all these columns and press OK. So it has removed my 3 duplicate values and it has found 10 unique names. I hope you like this video. Please don't forget to like, comment and share. Thank you for watching, guys.